Hi, this is Tim Martin. For this TMART Science Geology video series, we will learn about different types of rocks that can be found along the rock cycle. Let's go explore.
Hi, today I'm here in Eastern California at the shore of Crowley Lake. Behind me are the famous stone columns, and we can see that the rock here is igneous rock that was a pyroclastic flow that came out of the Long Valley volcano several hundred thousand years ago. This is a loose type of rock called tuff. It occurs when volcanic ash is kind of loosely cemented together. The erosion from the lake is creating these really unique features behind me. But one of the common rocks here is pumice. Pumice is an extrusive igneous rock. Again, you can tell by the light color that is a felsic rock, or it is, it's very similar to the rock rhyolite. And one of the unique things about pumice is it's very low density. It's so lightweight, it has a lower density than that of water. Look what happens when I drop these rocks down into the water.
So, how is pumice formed? Magma or lava is molten rock. Frequently, magma has a significant amount of dissolved gases, such as carbon dioxide. We're all familiar with another liquid with dissolved carbon dioxide. Just open a can of your favorite carbonated beverage. When the pressure is released, the CO2 comes out of solution and forms bubbles. Now imagine what would it look like if it was super cold outside. The bubbles or foam on top would freeze. That's exactly how pumice formed. Gas that was dissolved in the magma formed bubbles, and this pumice is frozen lava foam. In this case, the freezing temperature of the rock is over 1,000 degrees. All the trapped bubbles in this lava is what gives it a low density and why this rock easily floats on the cold, clear waters at Crowley Lake. Thanks for watching, and I hope you join me again on another video exploring rocks of the rock cycle.